Hey, what is up, guys, and welcome to this video. This is Sheepy, and this video will be a POV drive through the landscape of Germany. At the moment, we got autumn. We got some different colors on the trees. The leaves are partly red, partly yellow. I mean, you know it. It's really beautiful, and I've been searching for a relatively good place for this video, like for some good landscapes, and I'm pretty sure I found a good one with some hills. And yeah, I'm just gonna start the motor, and this is my Alfa Romeo 159 2.4 diesel in black sedan, and yeah, we're just gonna go right into it. And if you guys like some commentary with the videos, I'd really appreciate it if you give some feedback. Oh, it's gonna be close. But we made it. God damn. So yeah, I really really enjoy like just driving this car for no reason. Like if you go for a walk with your dog or something, it's pretty much the same. It's a lot of fun, and yeah, always pretty calming, pretty chilled. Driving through the nature. About 2 weeks ago, I've been. Wait, how's it called again? Like that thing if you. Oh my god, my English skills are so bad. If you work on your car with like a. Sponge, not exactly a sponge, like you're actually giving the color a new brighter and clearer look, like removing all the scratches, etc. and so on. It's a pretty good thing actually. I just don't remember the name at the moment. And I want to show you guys something. Like if you hear this, just hear the sound if this car passes by. God fucking damn it. And guys, this is a diesel. Sounds like some huge, I don't even know, but it sounds madly deep and powerful. Like one time I've been driving on a parking lot, and some dude actually asked me when I walked by, asked me what the engine is actually in this car. And he said it's got a pretty deep, strong, powerful sound. And yeah, I was pretty proud on that, and I told him, yeah, it's 2.4 liters, 5 cylinders. He actually expected that it's a 6 cylinder, but no. Because Alfa Romeo got a 3.2 6 cylinder V6, if I remember correctly. But actually, this car, like this engine is so awesome. Because you got, I mean, for me, it's so rare to have a 5-cylinder diesel. I mean, what car has an engine like this? The sound is awesome. You got so much torque until 4000 RPM, like it pushes and pushes and pushes. It's really one fucking mad engine. And it's so calming to drive. The difference between a 4-cylinder and a 5-cylinder is actually so big in my opinion, because the feel of the lower RPMs and the sound, like it all feels so much more smooth. It feels like a 6-cylinder actually. And like if you go under your casual idling RPM, this engine doesn't break down easily. Because, yeah, for some reason, like, it always pulls itself up, like, if you're even at 500 RPM, or I'm pretty sure I even touched 400 one time, but 500 RPM is pretty much safe, easily possible. Like, it will push itself up again, and, like, the Mazda MZR 2.2 CD, I've sometime driven that car too, like, it's a car from my dad. And if I drop below 750 RPM, the engine just breaks down and kills. Like, it's over. But this engine, it's like, no, hell nah, bruh. I don't do this shit. Like, it's really awesome. And, yeah, the fuel consumption is about, according to my drive style, like, I love pushing this thing. Not too much, sometime, about 7.5 to 8.5-9 liters or something. And it's for this engine size actually totally okay in my opinion. Like, I drove a BMW 369 with a 1.8 liters E46, 1.8 liters gasoline engine, and that engine ate much more fuel actually than this, funnily, because I don't know, it always felt like I gotta hold it at a kind of minimum RPM, because the Vanos actually opened up at about 2000 RPM, and if you push that engine a little bit, it drinks so much fuel. It was really inefficient, and it was slow actually. Like, for a first car it was awesome, but comparing this, I'm really happy that I don't got it anymore, because it costs way too much money. Look at this Alfa Romeo Giulietta, but I don't know what engine this thing got, but that Alfa Romeo Giulietta QV, pretty sure that's the name of it. It's like a competitor of the BMW M3. It's got a V6 engine with 510 horsepower. And man, that thing looks fucking sexy. Like, I'm gonna do a car porn or something, or a show of this car soon. I just gotta find the right place and the right moment for this, and gotta clean it up. But in my opinion, this car, the Alfa Romeo 159, is the best looking Alfa Romeo of all. Like, I couldn't imagine driving a better looking car than this, to be honest. Like, the whole story of this thing was, one time I've seen this car on the parking lot, and I was like, god damn, what is this? And I was like, it was a first love, no, a love on the first sight, or how's it called, you know what I mean? And I definitely needed to know what this car was called. So yeah, I did it, I knew it. Oh yeah, this is a 159 Alfa Romeo, alright, good to know. Yeah, that was like pretty much my thought. I don't know if I researched it actually in the in Google or something. I don't remember exactly, but I definitely needed to buy this car. Like I saw it in my eyes, like in my mind that I'm gonna drive this car. So yeah, I did it. I do it, and it's fucking awesome. I love this car. I madly love this car. Like from oh, there's an hey, cool, another Alfa Romeo. Like this is so fucking awesome. It's like a community or something. If you actually show you raise your hand like, oh hey mates, I also drive an Alfa Romeo, what's up? Like they all pretty much all raise their hands too. Like it's like with the bikers, so they do it too. It's really amazing, and it's always so positive. Like this feels so different than the. It's not like a competition mode or something. It's so just calmed driving and a calm community. Like also in the forums in the internet. It's something different than the German cars, in my opinion. And yeah, back again to the topic. So I bought this car. And from the front to the back, the whole thing, like this aggressive front, it kind of looks like a Bugatti, actually. But this car design was before the Bugatti. So Bugatti, if you compare it, and if you would say Bugatti looks like this, Bugatti, yeah, no, I'm pretty sure they didn't stole or whatever, or, but maybe they oriented, or how's it called again? Fucking English skills, like they saw this car maybe and thought, oh yeah, we could design it a little bit in that way or something, if you know what I mean. But yeah, these three single front lights on every side and this all like view, like it looks so fucking aggressive. Like it's gonna eat something, I don't know, it's gonna eat every car in front of it or something like that. Yeah, the long hood, also with this V form to both sides, from the tires to the grille on the front. The side view, like you got the blinkers and the door knobs, or like where you open the door, you know, the thing you're gonna pull it away and open the door, whatever. And it's all in one line. Like you really got a clear design lineage on this car. Like how's the designer called again? Jugario or something. But he really did a fucking great job. Yeah, absolutely sexy, sporty side view. The back, like some people say that they like the sport wagon or so, or whatever, more than the sedan. But for me, actually, I like the sedan more than the sport wagon. It looks more elegant and yeah, a little bit. Nah, I'm not sure if it's actually longer, but it looks better in my opinion. So yeah, you can get this car with some several variations of engines, starting with the 1.75 liters TBI with 240 or 220 horsepower, something like that. It's turbocharged. Going to the 2.2 JTS engine, Twin Spark technology. I don't know if there's something in between those sizes, those displacements. But Then you got the 3.2. Is it called Busso? Is that right, maybe? Busso engine? But it's in a range of 260 horsepower or something, if I'm not wrong. And according to the diesels, you got a 1.9 JTDM engine with either 150 or 170 horsepower. Yeah, it should be like that. Correct me if I'm wrong. 2.0 liters JTDM engine, two. Oh no, that's the one with the 178 HP. And the 2.4 liters JTDM 5-cylinder with 200 horsepower, 400 Newton meters. And that's the engine I got in this car. Yeah, just always thinking about that this car, like the engine itself, it's so special. It's so cool, like just the feeling that you have a 5-cylinder diesel in this. It's just cool. It's really just cool. Yeah. Alright, I'm gonna talk a little bit less now and just gonna enjoy the driving. So I hope you guys do too. And sorry for coughing. I've been ill the last week, but I'm getting better. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. It fell down to about 500 RPM and was just like, no, I ain't gonna do shit. I'm gonna push myself up. Like, this engine is just unkillable. Unkillable. Oh, and one topic I definitely want to talk about. A subscriber asked me on the in the comment section of the last video about this car, last and the first video about this car, how comfortable and the build quality of this car is. Starting with the comfortability or whatever. First of all, I've been driving this car a lot off the Autobahn, like going mostly at about 180 to 210 kilometers per hour with the automatic speed holding, like it's called Tempomat in Germany. I don't know if it's the same in English, but yeah, you just like accelerate. I just gotta activate my air conditioning. So you just gotta accelerate onto that speed, and then you just set like with this knob, like it's under the light knob, and you just push it up, and then it holds the speed. Like, I mean, you know that many cars today, like probably every car got that, but yeah, just holds it like easily. The engine holds that speed too with ease, actually, like, you know, and it's very well sealed. I've been talking to my passenger right next to me on the right on that speed. It was no problem at all. We didn't even have to like talk loud or something. It was easily. It was so calm, actually. And yeah, it felt really safe too. Like the wind noise is very quiet, in my opinion, compared to other cars. And the car also in the curves, it doesn't like shake or something, or go strongly to the left, to the right, you know what I mean. It handles all these things together really, really good. It really does feel very safe. I got heated seats. Like if it's getting a little bit colder, I just activate that. I got this car got three different steps in that, like 1, 2, 3. One is the lowest and 3 is the highest. Yeah, and makes a long drive very, very comfortable. I drove about 4 hours in a row without a brake with this car, and I had no problems with the seat or with sitting. It didn't hurt or something. There are a lot of things you can set on the seats, actually. I gotta show you that in another video, but they are very comfortable. Like, you just lay back in the seat and drive, and it's like sitting at home in a good quality chair with a good bolster. Yeah, it just doesn't really feel like a car seat, actually. Not meaning that the car seat is bad or something. No, this is great. It's great. Yeah, the engine, as I said, is really, really smooth. I don't know. That should be actually everything to the comfortability while driving. And also the speedometer, no, not the speedometer, like these things, the barometer from the turbo, the temperature from the water, all these things, the radio, they are all slightly turned to your side, like in my previous BMW, which make it easy to reach anything here, like it's absolutely easy to touch something, to set your stuff up or something. Oh, and this is also really great. This is a navigation system. It's from, I don't know, 2006 or something. It runs with a CD. Like, that's it, actually. And the CD has the data, the cards, the maps. And it's good. I mean, you can even set the address if I go to navigation. There you see the map. And I can set the address, just search it. Like, I got GPS in this car. I can even call somebody or something. I can give my SIM card in this one right there, and I can call while driving. And I got this handy connected via Bluetooth with this radio, but it's with the external adapter. Anyways, this thing works really great, even if it's old and got not the best resolution of the display. It works really great. It didn't even crash or something yet. It has no bugs. It's actually kind. Nah, it's not the smoothest, but I mean, what do you expect? It's not like a handy from 2015, 2016 or some shit. But yeah, and the build quality, the only thing I hear or I see when I like turn the windows down and up again, like I'm pretty sure I already said that in the comment section of the video, when it reaches the rubber seal, it makes a lightly squeaky noise. But the first time you hear that, maybe the second to fifth time too, but after that you don't give a fuck. So yeah, except of that, like this is aluminium, it's all leather, all it's about it's like this is called distinctive. It's the Ausstattungslinie is a word in Germany. Yeah, I'm gonna say that in the comment section later, never mind. But yeah, the build quality is great. There's nothing I can say except the window thing. And I'm true, I don't talk like, because this is my car, I don't say that everything is great. I'm saying the reality. Yeah, so man, this weather is really not the best. But yeah. Dude. Why do people always, like mostly, gotta not go exactly 50 kilometers per hour? Or slower, or something in the range of 40? Like, I always go about 60, honestly. Or like, no, 57 or something. And I also didn't know that the VW Charan in front of me is also built with a 1.8T engine. Like, this engine is pretty famous. I didn't know that. It's interesting. And I wanna correct me, actually. I said that this car is the best looking Alfa Romeo. Yeah, that's absolutely true. But I mean, not only the best Alfa Romeo. Sure, there are some really fucking awesome cars. But talking about the car, you can actually afford like, this car, in my opinion, looks better than 99% of the cars you see in the middle class to high class, if you know what I'm talking about. In my opinion, it's one of the sexiest designs a car has ever had. Like, it's fucking amazing. And I see that if I go out of this car and I see people looking at this car, turning their heads, or because of the engine sounds or whatever, it makes you proud. And it actually looks like a car that should be in the price range of, I don't know, man, but something slightly under the, slightly under the BMW M3 or something, or maybe M4, yeah, M4, something like that. Like, this is just my view, it's my opinion. But for me, I fucking love this. And so I pretty much don't give a fuck if somebody got a better car or whatever. Like, if you buy a car for you, buy it for you. That was weird. I should have braked. And for the next video, guys, I'm not gonna introduce me as Sheepy, because I don't know. That feels kinda off. Just call me Tom. Actually, at the moment with 140 kilometers per hour and rain. Alright, it's not too quiet, but it's really okay. It's really okay. But BMW was a lot louder. Thank you, Julia. Where is this guy gonna go left? Not right. Hell no. Dude. where the fuck did he go? This dude is on speed. God damn, this is fun. This is really fucking cool. Well guys, my battery is almost empty. It's gonna die pretty soon. So I'm just gonna break here. Alright. So if you watched until this, thank you very much. And I wish you a good day. And we're gonna talk to each other in the next video. Goodbye.